Well, I love Simpsons. Giuseppe loves The Simpsons.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody loves The Simpsons. And if you look at the views, yeah, it's really everybody who loves The Simpsons. So I think we do another couple of videos on maths and The Simpsons. And today it's actually going to be one on higher maths in The Simpsons. So let's just watch this clip and talk about it a bit.
Where I was recruited by a card-counting ring. I won enough money to buy fake SAT scores I used to get into the real MIT. Where I failed every class and was kicked out and had to move to Springfield.
Okay. Now, we're not going to talk about card counting today. We're going to do a video on card counting. Now, what we're going to talk about is this blackboard that shows up in here. Okay? That's a really, really nice one. Okay. So there's a lot of really nice mathematics in there, and I'd like to make sense of it, okay, together with you. All right, so let's have a really, really close-up look. So let's just start out with that symbol up there. So there's a squiggly sign in there, okay? That stands for sum in mathematics, in this case, an infinite sum. All right, let's just take it apart. So here we go. So x equals 1, then 1 divided by 1 is?
1.
Then put x equals to 2, 1 divided by 1 half.
Yeah.
And then next one, put 3 in there, you get
a third
and a fourth. And the infinity up there tells you that you should go on, you know? So it just goes on forever, right? So that's an infinite sum, right? It's infinite sum. And it starts out like 1, but then it gets smaller and smaller and smaller and kind of dies out as you get further and further this way, okay? So that's infinite sum, some sorts of something, who knows? Okay. Now, what is, comes next? Well, then we do these sorts of manipulation. There's a bracket with two terms in it. What does that correspond to in this way of writing it?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it just corresponds to bracketing things like that, okay? Now, there's a bit of algebra happening here, and it's all okay, right? So as far as maths is concerned, what they're doing here is all okay. So I'm not going to go into the details there. Let's just skip to this line here. Something interesting is happening there. You actually come across the same sum that you started out with, okay? So there it is again, okay? And so let's just forget about the rest. There's something else here in this line. Move it together. So that's basically what this all says so far, right? So we've got something here, we've got something there, and then we've also got something here. And obviously we can cancel those two guys out, right? And that makes this term here 0. So that's the conclusion we draw from all this so far, okay? This guy is equal to 0. Now there's a bit more algebra, which is all fine as far as maths is concerned, which then tells you that this guy here, you know, algebra, is equal to 1 minus 1 half plus 1 third, and so on. So basically the sum that we started with, except that every second plus has been changed into a minus, okay? Okay, so that's supposed to be 0. Except it's pretty obvious that it's not, right? Because if you bracket things like that, you see that 1 minus 1 half is definitely something something positive.
Yep.
And that guy here is also going to be something positive. And that one's going to be something positive. There's no negatives in there. So it's got to add up to something positive. It can't possibly be 0. And actually, if you know a little bit of calculus, you actually recognize this infinite sum as something that adds up to something else very famous, log 2. This thing actually adds up to 0.69314. And actually, if you have a really, really close look at what's cancelled out here, there's kind of a 4 in the end. So I think that's what actually was supposed to be here. Right? So there's a contradiction here. There's a contradiction here. You know, basically, it's what it says so far, and everything seems fine, is that this log 2 is equal to 0, which is definitely not.
So does it mean that MIT had it wrong in their board?
Well, let's figure it out, okay? Let's figure it out. But before we move on, right, I've just been commenting to no end on the 9.999 recurring equals 10 video. And basically that is about infinite sums. And there was like lots of people coming in saying, well, what's with all these infinite sums? They, you know, they're not really of any use. You know, so why do you talk about them? You know, it's yeah. Well, I said it there and I really want to say it today. These infinite sums are what makes calculus work. Without infinite sums, forget about calculus, okay? And just to illustrate what's going on, you know, one of the instances where this comes up is, actually where this insight here comes from. So it actually turns out that you can represent the function log of something as an infinite sum with a variable in it. Okay, so so you can for t you can actually put any number between minus 1 and 1 in there, and it will tell you what the corresponding log of that number here is. So for example, if I put 1 in here, then it will tell me what log 2 is. If I put 1 half in here, it will tell me what log 1 and a half is, and so on. And well, why is this good? Well, these functions are very complicated, right? Very hard to kind of calculate these sorts of things. But if you have a representation like this here, if you have a representation like this, what you can do is you can find very good approximations to these numbers that are very hard to calculate by just kind of chopping off this infinite sum at some point, and then just calculating whatever is left over. So maybe you just chop it off at 50 terms here, and then it's just kind of products and sums. It's very easy to calculate, and that will give you this approximation here. When you sometimes hear on the news, pi has been calculated for another trillion digits. Well, the way they do it is via infinite sums. And just in general, infinite sums are really good, okay?
That doesn't mean that pi has a trillion digits, like that stops at a trillion digits.
No, of course not, it just keeps on going.
They stop their calculation there.
That's right.
Their computer melted down probably.
That's right, and you just need a couple more of those terms and then you get more. Anyway, infinite sums are really good. Now, how do we get out of this contradiction here? Well, let's just have another look here. So we've got here one number is equal to the same number plus log 2, okay? Now what's going on here? Everything seems to be all right, what we're doing here. There's another Simpsons clip which actually gives you a hint. Okay, let's just watch this one.
Hey, Flanders, it's no use praying. I already did the same thing and we can't both win.
Actually, Simpson, we were praying that no one gets hurt.
Oh, well, Flanders, it doesn't matter. This time tomorrow, you'll be wearing high heels.
Nope. You will.
Afraid not.
Afraid so.
Afraid not.
Afraid so.
Afraid not infinity.
Afraid so infinity plus one.
No.
What's infinity plus one?
It's infinity.
Oh, really? Okay.
So they tie.
They tie, right? Anyway, so this insert at infinity is infinity plus one gives us a really good hint of what's going on here, right? Because if you put any number in here, that's not going to work out. But if you put infinity there, that's actually going to work out. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, actually the only resolution to this whole thing is, because all the other maths is fine, is that this guy actually adds up to infinity, which is really cool. So this actually would make it right. Okay. Okay, well, I mean, it's a very complicated way of showing that this sum is infinity. So I want to show you another one, which is actually a real classic. It dates back a couple of hundred years. And it's been brilliant then, it's still brilliant now. I teach it in first year calculus. So the standard proof, the nicest proof, in many ways the nicest proof that this sum here is infinity, which at first sight is actually quite surprising, right? Because these things really die out there. So you might think, well, maybe it adds up to something finite, but this guy, no, it adds up to infinity. Okay, so how do we do this? Okay, so first thing is we create a second infinite sum, okay? And I just put down a couple of the terms there. So this one here coincides with the guy on top with all the terms that have a power of 2 there. So there's a 2 here, a 4 here, 8 here, the next one would be 16, next one would be 32, and so on. Okay, all those stay the same. Now all the other terms that I haven't written here are going to actually be smaller than the corresponding terms up there. So this 1/3, for example, are replaced by 1/4. 1/4. This 1/5 I replaced by 1/8, makes it smaller. That one here also by 1/8, that's one by 1/8. Okay, now what about this one here? What do I replace it by?
1/16.
1/16, and the next one?
1/16.
Yeah, and you just keep on going until you hit 1/16, and then it keeps on going with
1/32.
Yeah, okay. All right, so we just keep on going like this. And now if you just compare this sum to that sum, you know, if this added up to a number, you know, we replace stuff here by things that are smaller. So this should actually add up to something that's smaller, right? Well, if it's infinity, then it might stay infinity or might turn into a number, doesn't matter. But definitely, this one's not getting bigger, right? This one's definitely not getting bigger. I mean, that's absolutely clear, right? And now, the ingenious bit here is we also bracket things in a nice way. We bracket them like this. Okay, so what does this bracket add up to? Well, there's only one term in it, so it's 1/2. What about this one here? 1/4 plus 1/4 is?
It's a half.
It's a half. What about this one here?
It's a half.
It's a half too. And this one here?
It's going to be a
half. So every single one of those rectangles has a half in it. So this second sum really adds up to 1 + 1/2 + 1/2 + 1/2 + 1/2 infinitely often, and that's obviously infinity, right? Infinity. So that guy is definitely infinity, and that one
is bigger than
well, it's got to be infinity then, right? So I mean, that's just an absolute beauty, right? And that's another Maths and the Simpsons video for you, this time about higher maths and Simpsons. And the next one we're going to do is going to be even higher maths.